Hi there, today's video is all about what not to do on a first date because I've done my fair share of dating and going on a first date can be equal parts exhilarating and of course nerve-wracking. What if you don't make a good first impression? What if he gets turned off by something you say? Or worse, what if, like all the other first dates you've had lately, you end up not liking each other by the end of the night? You might like him as a friend though not as a future romantic match, or maybe you do like him though he's not so into you. Now, before you completely freak out or decide dating is too hard, hear me out. Making a good impression on a date isn't all that difficult. If you follow these 9 tips of what not to do on a first date, you'll be in a powerful position to get a second date if you want one. Hi, I'm Nadine Piet, a dating and lasting attraction coach for smart, savvy women and the founder of Healthy You, Healthy Love. Now, before we continue, please be sure to comment below and let me know if there's anything specific you'd like help with and if there's a topic you'd like me to do a video on. I want to find out who you are and what your needs are so I can support you on your path to big, sexy love. And if you're new and haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please click the subscribe button and the bell button to get notified of my next video. So let's get back to talking about the new man you're meeting soon. I know first dates can seem like a drag, particularly in the digital dating world, and yet you've got to be in it to win it, which means my mission today is to help you to get over dating fatigue so that you can start to feel excited and confident about those first dates again. The good news is, despite all the uncertainties that come with it, there are things that you can control during the first date, starting with knowing the things you should avoid doing. So when you're on your first date with someone, number one, don't compare yourself to other women and assume you know what he's attracted to. This instantly puts you in a position of lack and insecurity. If you think you're not the woman for him or you doubt that he would be attracted to you, then you're not going to make a good first impression. You don't know what he's attracted to, so don't assume that you do. Be confident, back yourself, and be present. Get into your heart and out of your head so you can slow the mind down and be in the moment. To help you with this, you can practice these mantras multiple times a day before your date and even on your date. I'm attracting great love into my life. I am fully capable of giving and receiving love now. I hereby release anything and everything that is blocking the flow of love and joy to me now. Love flows freely. I approve of myself. I trust romantic love is steadily moving towards me in perfect timing. I'm lovable and divine. I deserve kindness. Now, it's not enough just to say them. You have to believe them and feel them. I'll post these mantras below in the description. Number two, don't think into the future. Thinking too far into the future takes you out of the moment and stops you from having fun on a date. This means no future pacing and no imagining what the relationship will look like if you two end up together, as this will only put unnecessary pressure on you and him. It's important to recognize that initial attraction does not mean that you are emotionally or physically compatible. This takes time to work out and rushing it is not an effective strategy. Of course, being attracted to someone is important, though early on, I suggest you ease up on this need to know everything on date one. For example, have you met someone in the past who at first you were not attracted to? Then over time they started to pique your interest. You were surprised that some romantic feelings had surfaced. Always remember that this kind of thing can happen with the men you meet, and no matter how you meet, whether it's online, through an app, an introduction through a friend, feeling can and do develop unexpectedly. I can't count how many times clients and friends have said to me, I didn't like my partner or husband when I first met him, or I wasn't attracted to him at first, then something clicked and all of a sudden he was gorgeous to me. Having an open mindset is a big part of increasing your dating success because your energy changes from judgment to intrigue. Remember, it's okay to meet men that aren't right for you. Keep going because soon you will meet a good match for you. Number three, don't forget to ask questions. The first date is the time to get to know each other. You won't get to know each other if you keep hogging the conversation. So be conscious whether the conversation starts feeling one-sided. If you share a detail about yourself, flip the question back to him so he can also talk about himself. Better yet, have those first date questions ready before the actual date so there won't be any awkward silences. But here's the thing, it's important to ask questions gently in a flowing, light-hearted way, even the bigger questions. No interrogations, no stern facial expressions, easy breezy. You're not a corporal drill master, you're a sexy lady who knows what she wants and goes about it gracefully. You see, asking him questions allows you to not only find out about him quicker, people like to talk about themselves, so he'll feel good being heard. But as I said, do it gracefully. Otherwise, he'll feel that future pressure from you, which we talked about in the previous point. Number four, don't talk over your date. It's generally considered rude to ask a question and not let the other person answer it in full. This is the time to show him that you're a great listener. When you ask questions, let him give you his answer. Don't talk over him, or worse, talk for him. Breathe and hold the space for him. It's in your interest to learn about him rather than fighting for the spotlight. Number five, don't talk about your exes. Now, this can be a little tricky to navigate as there are men who feel comfortable talking about past relationships on the first date. Do know that this is a case-by-case basis. A good rule of thumb to follow is if he prompted it, take that as a cue that this topic is okay, though keep it light and no woe is me or victim kind of talk. I suggest you smoothly and gracefully change the subject. If you've ever heard a man talk negatively about an ex, you'll know it's never great to hear, and it suggests that he's still not over it in some way. So I suggest you skim the topic, no deep diving. Number six, don't be late. This goes without saying. If you agree to meet at a certain time, be on time. Be considerate about his time, as you'd hope he'll be considerate with yours. And if you are late, always message or call to let him know that you're running a little behind. Number seven, don't forget your manners. You don't have to be uptight about the smallest things, but you do have to be aware of the basics. That includes not talking when your mouth is full, not getting drunk, 1 to 2 drinks max or no alcohol is even better, and not smoking without first asking if it's okay with your date. And always be kind to waiters and waitresses. General rule of life, be kind to people, all people. Number eight, don't be overtly controversial. Having an argument on a date is never a good start, and yet here's a twist worth mentioning. Psychiatrist Dr. Raj Pasod has done a lot of research on attraction and seduction, and his research reveals that if you were to disagree with your date on the first half of the date, then agree with him during the latter half, this will make you more attractive. His research did not reveal the reason why this was so seductive to a man, yet he thinks the idea behind this is that even though you disagree at the beginning, your date will believe that their impact on you eventually warmed you up to them, which makes them feel good. Of course, I don't recommend playing games with your date nor manipulating them, and yet Dr. Pasod makes an interesting point. Dating isn't just about trying to be agreeable and aligned on all topics. So how can you apply this research on your dates? I suggest if you talk about a topic and you have a different opinion to your date, then share your alternative perspective early on in the date. Then make the second half of the date more agreeable so that he and you leave the date feeling more aligned. Still, as the title of this tip suggests, I do not recommend being overtly confrontational or argumentative. Disagreeing with a man does not need to be done aggressively. You can have fun with it. So if you have an opinion you don't agree with, respect his opinion and disagree with manners. And if his opinions are deal breakers for you, you always have the option to not see him again. Number nine, don't expect him to pay for the date. This topic can be a little tricky. The bottom line is this: most men love it when a woman offers to pay her share and is prepared to pay if he says, okay, let's split it. If he insists on paying for the entire bill, be sure to thank him. This is really important as some women just expect it with no thank yous. So stand out by showing appreciation. I don't think there is a right or wrong way here. Some women love a man who pays and get turned off when a man doesn't. Other women can get offended when a man insists on paying. Of course, you do not owe a man anything if he pays, and if he doesn't pay, remember that women have been fighting for equality for a long time, and some women earn more than the men they date, so be careful to not dismiss a man if he doesn't pay. No matter what, always offer. And if you're not interested in the man, I think it's honourable to insist on paying your half. So many men feel like women are looking for a free ride, so be mindful of this. Of course, you'll have to discern what's best at the time, though these are my suggestions that tend to deliver the best outcomes. So there you have it, the 9 things to avoid doing on a date if you want to make a good first impression and go on that second date. Now before you go, please comment below and let me know which of these first date tips help you the most, and please share any dating tips of your own. And while you're at it, if you haven't yet, please subscribe to this channel, as this will allow me to keep creating these videos for you. Just hit the subscribe button below this video and the bell button to get notified of our new videos every week. Of course, if you have a friend who needs some first date support and encouragement, please share this with them, as it might be the very video they need to gain confidence and start a great relationship with the man of their dreams. It's a great honor to have you here with me. I encourage you to choose to show love a little more in some way every day, and see you at my next video.